Where do you think of in the United States when you hear the phrase high earthquake hazard? Perhaps California with its famous San Andreas Fault, or the far west coast of Washington and Oregon due to the long-term risk of a future dangerous Cascadia megathrust earthquake. It thus makes sense to the common person that these two respective regions are indeed classified as existing in a high earthquake hazard zone. Yet, if we zoom out the map, there are also a few high earthquake hazard zones that might surprise some people. For example, why is a portion of southern Illinois, Arkansas, Missouri, and three other states classified as being situated within a high-risk area? What about southeast Tennessee? Or southeast South Carolina? What about central northern Utah, southern Oklahoma, and why is a tiny strip of land in western Montana also shaded as being within the second highest threat category for earthquake hazards? This video will briefly discuss each of these regions and why they are rightfully classified as having what many in the public might perceive as an unexpectedly high earthquake hazard. Starting off with that little red sliver in Oklahoma, that marks a major fault line known as the Meers Willow Fault Line, which measures 112 miles or 180 kilometers long. This fault line is potentially capable of producing earthquakes rating as up to a magnitude 7.5 and even produced one such large earthquake in the low magnitude 7 range around the year 550. It, along with similarly trending faults, are related to a weak zone in the crust formed in association with one of the planet's worst mass extinction events 540 million years ago. During the late Ediacaran period, a series of large fault lines were created in association with the beginning stages of development of a third arm of a triple junction in what is known as the Southern Oklahoma Allocogan. This zone of weakness has remained ever since, which, despite a low rate of large earthquakes, still has the potential to one day produce them. Heading to northwest Arkansas and southeastern Missouri, we have a region that produced four highly destructive magnitude 7 earthquakes during a two-month time span between 1811 and 1812. Known as the New Madrid Seismic Zone, this feature is caused by the buried remains of a failed continental rift zone referred to as the Rillfoot Rift, which itself originated 565 million years ago. This rift created a series of faults which have produced magnitude 7.0 to 8.0 earthquakes about once every 1,125 years in recent times, including in 2350 BCE, 900 CE, 1450 CE, 1811, and 1812. Heading over to eastern Tennessee, we have the aptly named East Tennessee Seismic Zone. While this zone has never produced an earthquake larger than a magnitude 5.1 in historical times, it theoretically could produce earthquakes as large as magnitude 7.5. This region represents a long-term zone of weakness in the crust related to the Grenville orogeny, which largely occurred 1.1 to 1.0 billion years ago. Although the exact reason why this zone formed is uncertain, it left behind a series of large strike slip faults and what is referred to as a New York-Alabama lineament, and these seemingly accommodate some distant tectonic stresses. Heading to a portion of South Carolina which encompasses the city of Charleston, we have an area known as the Middleton Place Somerville Seismic Zone. This feature encompasses a series of faults related to a failed rift basin known as the South Georgia Rift Basin, which itself is associated with a Triassic-Jurassic mass extinction event approximately 201 million years ago. These faults have produced five presumably large magnitude 6 or 7 earthquakes in the last 5,000 years, including events around 1380 and 1600, along with a magnitude 7.0 earthquake in 1886. As for the broad region of higher risk extending from Utah to Montana, with an additional arm extending through Idaho and far eastern Oregon, this marks what is known as the Intermountain Seismic Belt. Here, numerous large fault lines are created to accommodate stress related to a sudden jump in the thickness of the lithospheric crust. Horizontally moving mantle material interacts with this, slowing down and transferring stress to the crust. As a result, numerous large normal faults were created, with the most significant being the Wasatch Fault in Utah, the Teton Fault in Wyoming, and the Lost River Fault in Idaho. Since 1900, this broad area has been the site of 8 magnitude 6 and 1 magnitude 7 earthquakes. As for that little dot in western Montana, that represents where a magnitude 5.5 earthquake struck in 1952. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.